Hey, sorry I'm a little late, but damn, it feels good to be back. I took a little break to recharge my body and mind after Freedom Bound, and once I came back, I got a little run for my money by Otto, of all people. Matt, I guess you found out the hard way, huh? Anyway, as soon as the Uprising tournament started, there was nothing that could break my focus. I needed this. I needed it more than anyone could imagine. I can't fight for a championship for another 8 months. But I promise as soon as I can, you best believe I'll be champ again. Until then, I'm gonna keep doing my thing. I'll take on anyone and everyone. Whoever wants to get in the ring with me, you got it. It's gonna be a fun 8 months.
Well, this is it. Brand new Pulse Arena, brand new era for Pulse. And we're going to get it kicked off with the, I hate to say it, quote-unquote loser's bracket from last night's Uprising tournament. Granat, Aiden, let's see who wins this one.
This isn't a loser's bracket when you get fireworks like this. This is amazing.
That's one way to
start. Look at those pyro.
That's definitely a way to start off Pulse. Granat, I'm sorry to say, this match was scheduled. So whoever was going to lose both matches at Uprising last night, the semis, they were going to fight in the first match of Pulse here.
God, I love that.
It is impressive. But Aiden O'Brien, I don't have to explain to anybody who's seen it, took a hell of a beating last night from Meyers Posey.
Oh, no
pretty,
doubt.
Pretty ruthless, to be honest with you. He needed about 9 stitches to close the wound on his head shut. And if he didn't feel like wrestling tonight, I would have no problem rescheduling this match. He wanted to be here tonight. So here comes Aiden O'Brien.
I mean, fresh...
I mean, he's got the bandages on his head like a target. I mean, you can't go without him, honestly, at this point. But he's a brave son of a bitch, I'll tell you that right now. Because there's no way, no how I would get in the ring after wrestling a match like that one night after it happened. I just wouldn't do it. Well, what about you, Tucker? Well, Tucker, you're going to be in action tonight. You know that, right? Obviously, you know that.
Yeah, I know it.
Taking on Otto?
Going to happen.
Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
I've never been in the ring with him, so I can't really give you any tips, but I think you could do it.
Oh, you've been in the ring with Otto plenty of times.
The last time I stepped in the ring with him was like 3 months ago when I beat him in the cage match. He's definitely evolved as a wrestler since then.
Don't say that. Please don't say that.
I'm just saying. Watch out.
I mean, because I remember kicking his ass in the backstage. I mean...
Well, yeah, exactly, so... So
you should be the bigger vision.
You got it. Well, let's kick off Pulse the right way. Let's see who wins this match and gets much needed momentum going forward. Or for Aiden O'Brien, I think survival is really just the key here.
Oh,
make
definitely.
Sure you don't take too much damage. Suplex.
Because that could definitely those stitches could definitely come back to haunt him.
For sure, but he's starting off pretty well now.
Very big target, and getting those things busted open, that's just gonna be hell on earth.
Absolutely, but he's definitely got Granat in his hands right now. What is he going for here? He's bending that arm back in a very unnatural way.
Ugh.
Oh! Stops right on the middle of his arm. That's one way to dislocate his elbow.
I don't know how he didn't break it.
We don't know that he didn't. Well, I mean, Granat would probably be screaming in pain, but that still does some serious damage. Granat's fighting back.
There we go. Now he's getting some kicks in.
Kick to the gut. Granat perched on the second rope. Sunset flip into a pin. We got a cover. First cover of the night.
One. Two.
Just a one count. Aiden kicks out. He's still in this. Springboard moonsault, though, by Granat.
He cleared almost the entire ring on that one.
He did, and he's going outside. What's he... Springboard frog splash. I think Aiden might have saved himself by rolling over there. You got to think he would have went for a cover if he landed on
top. Oh, definitely.
Top. Granat got in mind here. He's got his arms wrapped around his waist. Beautiful German suplex. The strength that that takes.
That was a bit of an awkward German suplex. I mean, not a bad one, but just...
That's just showing off the strength.
That's just showing off strength.
Going for another suplex here. Regular suplex. Floats into a cover. Into a pin.
One.
Just the one count. Hey, Aiden's hanging in there. Let's not count him out yet. He hasn't taken too much damage to that head.
Curse the commentator. It's probably going to happen now.
Well, let's see.
I don't know. What's he got going here?
He's going to the top rope. Oh, my God.
That definitely is going to cause some damage to his head.
Clotheslines Aiden off the apron. Aiden took a hard fall to the outside. Granat is not letting up. What has he got in mind here? He's surveying his prey. Wow, impressive.
He saw his chance, he went for it, and that was a dangerous play, but it played off. It paid off, no friggin' doubt.
Normally that would be a drop down moonsault, but he didn't drop down, he jumped up into it, also known as the Arabian Press. So Granat is showing off his best moveset here tonight. Oh, Aiden coming to the ring, but he walked right into an elbow. Irish whip.
Oh, nice jump.
Into a, wow, hard cross body. Granat is total control of this one.
Here. One. Two.
A two count.
Three.
Ooh, we got a three. Wow. That was pretty much what I expected. Aiden O'Brien had a good start to the match, but he just fell apart. And you can't really blame the guy. He's going in this with a severe head injury.
Definitely, but thankfully for him, I mean, he didn't take too much damage to the head, so I think he'll be all right.
I think he can live to fight another day. He can definitely heal, come back in a couple of weeks. He'll be okay, but Granat gets a big
win. Give him about a week and a half. I mean, stitches.
Yeah, I don't know if we're going to see him next week. I would have given him tonight off, honestly, if it was up to me. So he'll definitely get next week off at the least. So Aiden O'Brien, good on you for being here. Granat gets a win, a relatively quick win, which is good, because any longer, this could have got real bad. But impressive showing, a good way to kick off Pulse for tonight.
Yeah, and Granat definitely showed us something else. I mean, he definitely pulled a lot of things out of his bag of tricks today.
Stuff we haven't seen before he showed us. So Granat is putting everybody on notice here that he's not going down with losing in the semifinals. So Granat's going to leave. He's going to celebrate. Up next, we got tag team action coming for you as Steven and Adam take on the Hollywood Elite. So we're going to get two teams that we haven't seen in this environment here. What do you think we're going to see? Think we're going to see an attitude change from any of these teams, or we're going to go with what we know? Well, Hollywood Elite certainly looks the
same. I think it's going to be... We haven't really seen anything like this, especially with the Gimps being... Oh, they're not the Gimps anymore.
Old habits die hard.
Exactly. We haven't seen them fight Hollywood Elite.
Well, I
can't even remember if they even fought them...
When they were the
Gimp days.
Maybe once. I believe I recall something, but we all know what happened there. So it's gonna be a fun match.
It's gonna be fun to see what they can pull out.
Because I think both teams really need some traction. Steven and Adam did, they have some wins over the TTPD, but they lost that cage match a couple of weeks ago. Hollywood Elite have gotten some victories as of late, but they're not that big tag team victory they've been looking for. So let's see if they can get it here tonight. Not much change seems with them. They got some new music, got some new attire, but other than that, they're the same old Nick and Brad. As far as I know, Tucker, Steven and Adam have given themselves a new tag team name. They're the Spectrum. What do you think of that?
I guess tiny skinny McDonald's over there? I don't know.
Tiny skinny McDonald's?
Yeah.
Well, two separate ones, you mean, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's pretty much what they're going for, I guess, the opposite end of the spectrum. They are, I guess they're just trying to shed that old Gimps moniker, so you stop calling them that.
I mean, it's really hard.
It is pretty tough, honestly. I fall into that trap myself when I'm thinking about it. But the Spectrum, Steven and Adam, let's see if they can go out and get
a good win. Look at Steven. It looks like he's bulked up a little bit since we've seen him last.
Could have been. They've had a couple of weeks, and really just a change of attitude completely since, they just became themselves, honestly. Well, this one's getting started. Oh, Brad Smith not wasting any time. Clothesline Steve into his own corner. Steve chops and now punches.
Look at the size difference on that one.
Very nice Northern Lights suplex. Yeah, this is a absolutely... The height difference is, I believe Steve is like 5'6", 5'7". Brad's going about 6'5". So you got a substantial height difference. I don't think that really matters right now. Steven's got this one in control. Nice knee into a neck breaker. Hey, height means nothing when you can do stuff like that. Get a cover.
One.
Grabs the ropes at one.
Ref actually sees it this time.
Well, he had a pretty good angle on that one.
Although we've seen that happen before with the refs.
That's true.
So caught up in the moment, they didn't even think to look at the ropes.
Brad rolls out of the ring. He's pretty proud of himself.
That's not going
to
be smart.
Steve goes to the outside. Tries to grab his legs. Didn't work. What a reverse DDT off that springboard.
I honestly don't think he saw that DDT coming in.
No, he tried
Brad
to grab Spence his legs.
Brad was caught completely off guard.
He thought he was going to get him. Steve jumped out of his grasp and hit that DDT. That was insane. Steve's telling him to get up. I'm surprised with the size difference that we have Steve in such control right now. Springboard.
Size isn't everything.
My God, he just threw himself like a missile at him.
I think it's the shorter wrestlers that have more of an advantage. Their center gravity's lower.
Uh-oh, but we got beautiful senton bomb off the second rope. Not only does that take even more ability, because you're not going from a higher perch. You're obviously lower to the ground, so you got to turn faster. And look at the distance. Is he going for another one?
Oh!
He's just showing off at this point.
This is just a beatdown. That's a massacre.
Well, Brad needs to make a tag. That's what he needs.
Two.
You got a two count. No, Brad Smith kicks out. He absolutely has to get Nick Farrell in this match.
Well, if I'm Steve, I'm not going to let that happen.
Steve, I think, was going to make a tag. Brad Smith's not going to let it happen. DDT's him. Brad's getting him up now. Now, if you remember, a couple of weeks ago, Nick Farrell actually pinned Stephen Parker in a fatal four-way match, so he's got that advantage over him. Oh, that's good.
He's not even a legal man. Come on.
He is. Brad's not the legal man. He distracted Steve long enough for this cover.
Two.
Oh, foot was on the ropes.
That was a close one.
Foot was on the ropes.
Heartbreaking for...
Referee's telling Brad to get out of here. Oh, nice hip toss. Very nice hip toss.
Oh, he was looking for his partner there.
I'm sorry. That was a Japanese arm drag. That was not a hip toss. And you're not going to reach that far, Steve. Come on. He's trying to tag in Adam. I don't know what Adam is doing dancing around that pole, but he just cost his partner. Look at Nick. What is Nick Farrell doing? I think he's acting like he's Steve. All right, they're taking this Hollywood thing a little bit too far now.
Yeah.
He doesn't even realize what's happening. Oh, my God. Well, I guess that'll teach you to mock Stephen Parker.
Now he's actually wailing on the floor.
Yeah, exactly. We always knew Nick Farrell fancied himself an A-list actor, but I don't know if you did yourself any favors there. But Adam's in the ring now, and that's probably the last person Nick Farrell wants to see.
Ooh,
sits on his lower back. That's one way to herniate
a disc. That's a backbreaker right there. I don't think he's a masseuse.
I mean, speaking of injuries, I should touch on it right now as Brad Smith tagged
himself. Oh, tagged himself in.
Exactly.
That's smart.
After the main event last night, and now Nick Farrell punches him in the again. Look at this. After last night's main event, Joel, the former champ, now Joe Russo is the champion. Joel suffered bruised ribs. He is going to be out for a few weeks. And oh my God, Adam might be out for a few months. What the hell? How is his knees not destroyed from that?
He tagged himself out.
I think he needs a little break, yeah. But he just dropped nearly 400 pounds that high on his knees. Beautiful moonsault by Nick Farrell. Struggles to get the big man over, but he is on top. One. Just a one count. Gonna take a little bit more pressure than that to keep Adam down. To the gut. Punch in the face.
It's clobbering time.
Yeah. Farrell, Irish whip. Takes him out of his corner, puts him into the Hollywood Elite's corner. Smart strategy. We got a tag.
Here.
Ooh. Very nice double team maneuver. Drops down.
Look that big.
Oh
no.
Steve gets drop kicked.
Oh, he's getting up.
Yeah, Adam's getting up.
Keep the big man down.
Catches Brad and headbutts him.
Headbutt.
He almost devoured his head like it was a Big Mac. Sorry, I'm taking your gimmick. I apologize. Adam clubs down Brad with a double axe handle. Now, if his knees weren't hurt before, they might be now. Irish whip. Now he's got him in his corner now. This is where he wants him to be.
Texas. What do they got? I wonder what they're going to show us.
Flapjack into a knee to the face. That's a great maneuver for these guys.
Tell him to get up. Steve's got something in mind.
Steve got going on here.
A couple punches.
He elbows him in the hate, in the face. Jeez. Northern Lights. Nice Northern Lights suplex.
There you go. And see, he's definitely showing. This is a new Steve. There's a new Adam. Even more so than when they were fighting the TTPD. This is
a very favorable matchup for him, exactly. Yes. Not to take away from the Hollywood Elite. They fought in this match too, but what's Steve got in mind here? Beautiful toe make on Hilo over the top rope.
The Hollywood Elite are just, they gotta find something and deepen downside of them.
If I'm Brad Smith, I'm tagging to Nick Farrell immediately, because Nick Farrell, to be by comparison's sake, has not even suffered at all what Brad Smith has. Springboard did not connect. Misses the frog splash. That was a hard landing.
Good for Steve if he would have hit that.
Here comes Nick. He gets tagged in. Steven's going to make a tag. No. Oh, he tried to catch Nick Farrell, but he got caught with a leg lariat himself. Nick just looks frustrated at this point. Oh, my God. Dropping the knee.
I'm still thinking about the old mantra of them being in the Gimps, you know.
Yeah, it could be. Look at this submission. Oh, it was only broken up by the fact his foot was under the rope, but Nick's going up top. He just drops down to punch Adam in the face.
I think he slipped.
I don't know, but he took it out on Adam nonetheless. He's going up top again now.
Oh, this isn't good for him.
He's telling Steve to get up. What's he got in mind here? Oh, wait a minute. He changes. Changes course. Oh, my God. That is completely unintentional miscommunication, but Steve might have just done some damage to his own partner after he got drop kicked. Referee stops Nick from capitalizing even more. Well, for a moment he did. Adam might have just got taken out of the match. Might have got taken out again. Corkscrew plancha. I think Nick Farrell.
This is going to be the Steve show now.
He was focused on the wrong guy. Steve catches him with a suplex in the ring. Look at Brad Smith. He can barely even hold himself.
He's hanging on to your life.
Yeah. Oh! Backstabber by Steve.
That's lethal. And then Adam's he's getting right up. He's a champ.
He's up on the corner. Steve got in mind here. Nick Farrell is definitely worse for wear. Nice leg lariat. I'm impressed by Steve and Adam right now.
They're definitely showing something we've never seen before.
He arched him in the corner. He arched him so hard, Adam had to get off the apron. Brad's trying to get in the ring. Referee's got to tell him no. Meanwhile, we got a tag to Adam. Uh-oh, what do we got? Oh, we've seen this before, if I know what's coming. Rolling senton 450. Oh, don't do it, Adam, please. You're going to kill him. No!
That's it. That's it. Go for the cover. You got the pin.
One thing when you do that to Avery, but to Nick Farrell.
Two. Three.
I don't think we
No way you get up after that.
Oh, my God.
That was an entire ring he cleared there.
We got to see that again. That was a great tag team match. Hollywood Elite, they were in this. They weren't completely out of it, but Steven and Adam just were on all cylinders tonight, and they fought hard.
This is the best time. We've never seen them fight this hard.
No, that was a great win. That was a career-defining win, if I do say so myself. They're on the right track for sure.
Seeing some great things from them, and I can't wait. And to think, the one good thing the GM did.
We don't talk about that anymore. Look at this. This is a great double team move. Flapjack into the face buster.
Getting these people on the radar.
Unfortunately, Maryland back there is having fun. We're not going to see the replay of the finish, but you just saw it anyway. It was a hell of a moonsault by the near 400-pounder. These guys are looking good. So, you think future tag team number one contenders? Order got to watch out?
I think they got something to prove. I mean, they've already proved a little bit, but they've got a long way to go, but I think they can do it.
Oh, absolutely. Up next, we got Meyers Posey. Meyers Posey, I don't know why I even have him on this show, but he's here. And I don't know why, because I last night, like, what he did to Aiden was despicable. You agree with that, right?
It was definitely over the top, but Aiden looked like he was no worse for it. I mean, he, yeah, stitched tonight, the course, yeah. But and it was hard. But
absolutely,
I think it'll be fine.
You think he learned his lesson a little bit after Jackson gave him three good nights and won the Uprising tournament?
I think he's just probably wanting to forget that and move on.
Think so? Well, we'll see. Yeah. But we heard from Jackson Montgomery earlier, obviously. Like we touched on, he is the Uprising champion, and he cannot use the benefits of being the Uprising champion for about 8 months. So he, well, I guess he's going to do the whole open challenge thing again, just fight anybody who wants to fight him. You think that's the, I mean, I guess that's the best way to go, right?
Yeah, I mean.
It's the only thing he can do.
We might be seeing maybe a bit of a rematch here with Meyers Posey and Jackson at some point.
I would
that
not
case.
Be surprised for Myers to want to go out for revenge, because I won't say he got embarrassed, but at the end there, he got embarrassed. That's yeah. Pretty much all we can say.
Just to be taken out like that.
After he started the match, Myers Posey jumped Jackson backstage, but on his way to the ring.
And we saw a lot of that last night.
And we saw that, and then we saw Joel and Joe start a very similar way. Both matches have a little bit of bad blood. I think Myers is not going to forgive Jackson so easily. So if I'm Eric Campbell, who he's fighting right now, I'm probably not too happy that I got to go against Meyers Posey right now.
No, definitely I wouldn't be happy either.
Well, Eric Campbell's got some news. Of course, we have not gotten the funds enough to get him a new entrance video, but that will come with time, Eric. I promise. There's only so much money to go around. And, apparently, Otto signed a new contract last night saying that he does not have to pay for the ring. I don't know why that happened, but I guess we'll just...
Who offered him that contract?
I don't know what you're talking about. I think you did that.
Oh, yeah.
Co-owner.
Yeah.
All right, so Eric Campbell is in the ring now. Eric Campbell qualified for the quarterfinals of the Uprising tournament, which we actually didn't really see coming. He beat Masahiro. Speaking of Masahiro, your boy Masahiro now, it seems. He is going to be taking on Pierce next week in a match that I'm very much looking forward to, but that will be
next
week.
That'll be fun to see.
That'll be a lot of fun to see, the way Pierce reacts to what Masahiro did to him last week. But that is neither here, it's there. Right here, though, Eric Campbell's taking on Meyers Posey.
Whoa!
Wow, almost takes his legs out.
That was a quick one.
I think he was just waiting for Meyers to do something. He didn't do anything, and he took it to himself. Meyers misses the super kick. Eric misses a back kick. Eric Campbell standing toe-to-toe with the big man. I can't say I saw this one coming. Speaking of, Tucker, do you see the CME logos are gone from the turnbuckle in the back? Is Marilyn playing with the video back there? Marilyn, please fix that by the next break. We got a one count. That's what happens when we hire Marilyn to do our video editing. Either way, though, you know you're watching a CME product when these two guys are in the ring. Already.
Here it is.
I think he's taking offense to the fact that Eric Campbell tried to start the match up toe-to-toe with him. I think Meyers Posey takes offense to almost everything that happens to him. He's just pulling on his face. This is just... The referee's got to step in there. Oh, Eric! Drops out underneath! Eric Campbell's got something to prove. If he can beat Meyers Posey, that's gonna really propel his career up. Oh, he's got him in a headlock. Elbowing Meyers. That's a taste of his own medicine right there. So, Tucker, are you thinking about your match coming up next against Otto?
I'm focusing.
It's a big
I'm getting. I'm getting into the zone. I'm going to need it.
Meyers drops down, counters with Fireman's carry. Somebody in the audience is single, so they want you to marry them. But Eric Campbell in the ring. Nice arm breaker. I'm impressed by Eric so far. Let's go for a cover.
One, two.
Oh, no, we got a two count. Wow.
Oh, the ref's hand hit the mat.
That's how close that was. Meyers Posey just escaping by the skin of his teeth. He knocks Eric's foot across. Then he hits a neck breaker. Is this going to be Meyers taking control? Oh, my God, just stomping
on him.
Complete disregard for any human safety with that one. Elbow drop to the knee. He's locking that leg up. Look at him punching away at that knee. Eric Campbell, if you haven't noticed, wears braces around his knees. So they're just like a walking target for a guy like Meyers Posey. Look, he's got a straitjacket lock on him. He's got his arms choking him out. Oh, my God. Wrenching that back across his knee. Eric Campbell might have to tap out here. I don't see any way out of this. This is brutal. And we say that every Meyers Posey match, because the man is just barbaric. Oh, Eric?
He somehow got... Wow.
Fights out. Uses Meyers' momentum against him.
That's how you do it.
Hey, Eric Campbell, this is probably one of his most impressive performances, if I say so myself.
Yeah, wrestling against a pissed off Meyers Posey? Yeah.
I gotta say, I would not have signed up for that match, but maybe he made a good call. Rolls Meyers across the map, and Meyers kicks him in the mouth. Oh, and it clotheslines him into the corner, stomps on him. That's just vicious.
Oh.
That's just vicious. I'd be surprised if he had any teeth left.
I think we just found the most... I think this Meyers Posey is the most vicious wrestler we have.
He's got a leg lock now. Oh. I don't know if he's going to reach the ropes. Oh, he doesn't have to. He kicks him in the face. Eric Campbell is fighting. He's fighting everything Meyers throws at him. Oh, but Meyers got him up. Oh, no. The Psycho Driver.
Hits
it face first. That's pretty much all she wrote. That's got to be it.
At least he's going for the cover. One. Two. Three.
Meyers Posey wins, but I'd be damned if I said Eric Campbell didn't give him a run for his money. That was a back and forth match.
Yeah, if it wasn't for that out of nowhere Psycho Driver, that could have gone another 5-10 minutes.
Yeah, Eric took his eyes off the prize for a split second. That's all it took for Meyers to drop him down. But hey, I was impressed by Eric Campbell. The guy I think has some potential. He's got a future here in CME. So if he can channel that, I think he's in for some big things. What about you?
Definitely. I just don't like that name.
He's improved his game since we started Pulse, since a year ago almost. I think he's gotten consistently better as the months have gone on. So let's just see what happens with Eric Campbell. Meyers Posey's happy that he...
I got a match, so I'm out of here. I'm going to get ready.
Well, we got a commercial break to go to. You can just...
Wait a second.
Oh, God. Are you kidding me?
That's the Meyers Posey that we all know and love.
And there's no reason for it. Eric Campbell's not said one cross word to Meyers Posey. It's simply because Eric Campbell had the nerve to wrestle him tonight, honestly. And the referee's not even safe. Come on. This guy has absolutely no sense of right and wrong. Again, look at this. He sees those braces as a target. That's absolutely what he sees. Oh, Eric's been busted open. He's bleeding pretty badly. Is this going to be a story of Meyers Posey? He's a bloodthirsty maniac.
I'm glad I delayed about half a second to see this show.
He's got Eric. Eric's bloody face is just perched up. He can't do anything about it. Oh, no. Side slam. He almost hit. Did she weigh his head whiplashed? Come on, ref. The ref just got... We got to get somebody out. We got to stop this. All right, we got to stop security out. Stop. Tucker, go get ready for your match. We're going to commercial break. We got to go to break. Get the camera off this sicko. All right, well, Tucker's supposed to fight Otto. Otto's walking to the rings for his match. We just punched Meyers in the face. That might not have been the smartest move, Otto. What in the world is going on? Meyers Posey just not only wrestled against Eric Campbell, he destroyed him after the match, and he's doing the same to Otto. Otto counters with an arm drag. This is not a match, ladies and gentlemen. My God, Otto is beating the crap out of Meyers. It's a good thing I haven't wrestled him in 3 months. Hey, he's done his job, Otto. You got to get to the ring. You got a match. Oh, this is not good. Oh my God. I'm surprised if he didn't dislocate his knee. All right, can we put that down, please? Not in Otto's face, come on. Oh my God. Face first, he goes into the... Do we not have security? Do we not have anybody? Jesus Christ. I mean, I don't like Otto as much as the next person, but this is just uncalled for. Meyers Posey's got it. Something has to be done about this guy. On the concrete. There's no mats here, ladies and gentlemen. Jesus. This is uncomfortable to watch. throws him into the... Jesus. Oh, my God. He throws him through the door. That's one way to open a door. I think Otto's too stupid to know how to open it any other way. Hell, even idiots don't deserve this. Myers gets him up. Otto can't even... I don't think he can see straight. He can't see anything now. He's got a garbage can over his head. Don't hit him with it. Don't. Oh, my... This is not right. We got a main event coming up next, ladies and gentlemen. Jackson taking on Salvaje. I'd really like to get to that match. If Meyers Posey could stop ruining the arena, that'd be great. Is there nobody in the locker room to stop this? There's no security back there. Not to the television. Oh, my God. Why are they watching Raw? Tonight is Pulse night, okay? Let's get that off next time. You could hear the impact of his back on that floor. That is not... I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. This is supposed to be a wrestling show, not a bum fights DVD. Yeah, you're proud of yourself, Myers. You beat the crap out of Eric Campbell. You made him a bloody mess, and you're doing the same thing to the bald wonder. It's good. I could beat Otto. I've beaten Otto many times before. It's not something to be proud of. He's about to give Otto PTSD in this locker room. I don't think he's going to use it again. Head first into the wooden drawer. Oh, I'm glad Tucker's wanted to fight this guy. We're not going to have a match with Tucker, ladies and gentlemen, by the way. This is not happening after this. Please don't powerbomb him. Please do not. Oh, my God. Folds him up. Now he's got him in a Boston Crab. There's no submissions here. There's no tap-outs. This is not a match. Otto's tapping out. He's in agony. Just leave. Yeah, oh, you made him tap out. Congratulations. That's not it. Oh, apparently spine buster. Yeah. Yeah, winner by knockout. Good job. That wasn't a match. Jackson Salvaje is next. This is great.
Oh, well, that was disappointing.
Yeah, that was disappointing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I really really wanted to see you go against Otto. What happened there?
I don't know. I mean, Myers is a loose cannon.
That's it? That's all that? You didn't have anything to do with that?
No, I didn't have anything to do with that.
All right. Well, I actually...
Because I want to fight Otto, but I mean...
I feel like I could believe that because Myers wasn't truly an insane person at this point. I mean, Myers walking through the curtain backstage... Saw Otto walking down the hall.
There is a possibility I could have had something to do with it. But I'm just going to say that I didn't have anything to do with it.
Okay, well we're going to reschedule that match for next week.
Yeah, I can't wait to see it. I can't wait to be there.
You're going to be in it. I can't wait to see it. You know what? That's going to be the first match on Pulse next week. You're going to take on Otto because that was supposed to be tonight. Meyers Posey, you're not welcome. Please do not show up. That's all I'm going to say about that, but it almost made me feel bad for the little bastard.
Is it really possible to feel bad for him?
Did you even see what happened?
I saw it on the monitors.
Yeah, you were out there in the ring. You probably saw it on the screen. But
yeah.
The only thing that didn't happen is his head wasn't split open. But other than that, that's just uncalled for. But, well, we got a main event to get to, ladies and gentlemen. Here is your Uprising champion, Jackson Montgomery, taking on all comers, taking on all challengers. Well, he's got one tonight in the television champ, Salvaje. Now, obviously, if this wasn't a self-imposed title strike or whatever, he would be fighting for the television title right now, but that's not happening. So it's a non-title match. What do you think is going to happen tonight? What do you think is going to go down?
Jackson did fight a hell of a match.
Two matches. Once against Granat, once against the man himself.
And Salvaje, I mean, he
fought Tim Tiburon last night and won in a very unorthodox fashion. With a handful of nads.
Yeah. But I think I'm going to have to give the edge to Salvaje on this one.
I mean, he is the television champ. I'm not going to take anything away from him at all. It's going to be a back-and-forth match here. If what happens in my head is going to happen in real life. These two are pretty they're pretty reputable. They've got a lot of talent, so let's see what happens here. Salvaje, I thought, would have learned his lesson after what happened with Granat and maybe not done the testicular torture, but I guess that's not true at all. So Jackson's got to watch out, is what I'm saying. Salvaje sure thinks a lot of himself, doesn't he?
Yeah. Less than Hollywood Elite, though.
A little bit, but the gyrating reminds me a little bit of Rick Rude. I don't know how we compare Salvaje to Rick Rude, but he would, probably. Let's get this one started.
I've noticed, out of the ring already.
I've noticed Salvaje, he's telling Jackson to come out there. I've noticed he has a habit of doing this. Like he just likes to play mind games. Oh, Jackson! Saw Salvaje turn his back for a second.
Jackson, Salvaje's trying to play mind games and Jackson goes along for the ride.
He just caught him with that arm, but he still caught him nonetheless. Salvaje tried to play ring around the rosy. Didn't work.
But he did have high ground, but Jackson got him right in the head.
Nice backflip up and over into a beautiful back suplex. The crowd is going wild for Jackson already. Oh, Salvaje is not, he's going wild in a completely different way on Jackson.
Whoa.
Oh, very nice. Kick to the face.
That was definitely playing possum there.
For sure. He baited him in and he went between the ropes. Oh, we got another cover. Early cover on Jackson. A little too early. Jackson kicks out. Vicious knife edge chop. Another one. Nice roll by Jackson. Corkscrew elbow. Well, this match is about as fast-paced as I expected. We got a cover by Jackson. Not a one count. I think these two are just trying to feel each other out. Nice back kick. Oh, these two are just trading kicks back and forth. Jackson's got him up. Michinoku driver. Not with a pin, though. He just gets off him. Jackson gets him up. Irish whip. Oh, we tried to catch Salvaje, but was a little bit off. Salvaje dodges it and kicks him in the head. Now, if you're Jackson, you really don't have much to lose now, do you?
I mean, not really.
You've got that title shot when you want it. You can't challenge for any other title, so.
But I don't think I don't think Jackson's the type to just kind of take it easy.
I mean, I don't think so. Well, he's taking it easy now.
Curse the commentator?
The crowd loves Jackson. He's just playing to the crowd. I'm pretty sure this man can do like the most heinous things, like pull a Meyers Posey, and he'd still get a beloved reaction from the crowd.
Yeah, he can do no wrong. Well, I mean,
maybe not to you.
Yeah.
Well, to you he could.
Yeah.
Counters the slam though. Salvaje kicks the leg out from underneath him. Salvaje got him on the apron. Jackson's perched on the apron. He has no idea what's coming. Oh, catches the foot. Okay. He did have an idea.
I heard that chop from here.
I could feel it from here. Jackson drops down. Salvaje into a handstand. A beautiful head scissor takedown. That's impressive. Going for a cover after that.
One.
Just a one count. Jackson's not going to give up. Well, that easily.
We're seeing some great aerobatics out of Salvaje today.
Well, Salvaje and Jackson's capable of it too, so let's see if he's got something he's going to pull out. Scooping a slam. Nice elbow drop.
We've seen Jackson fly like a majestic eagle.
I mean, he makes it look easy. Just like that suplex looks easy. That's not easy, ladies and gentlemen. Jackson got in mind here. I think he was just thinking about what he's going to do. He's going for the arm. Stomps on the elbow. Oh, look at Salvaje. He's not feeling too good about it. Jackson's got the legs. Oh, look, he's got a little swinging action. He almost threw him out of the ring. Salvaje's lucky.
I thought he was out of the ring bound.
Uh-oh, he's got this one set up. Oh, working on the knees. I thought he was going for a surfboard stretch. Was not. Wow! What a head scissor counter by Salvaje. Completely out of nowhere.
He saw Jackson bend over, and that was all he needed.
Oh my god, I've never seen somebody fall that hard on their face. That was a belly flop if I've ever seen it. Jackson got mine. Oh, he's got him cradled. Nice suplex. Another belly flop, but this time Jackson administered it. Put him up again. Another suplex. Jackson is the definition of a catch-as-catch-can wrestler. He can do everything. He can fly. He can wrestle you. He can brawl. He can throw out some submissions. So he is the perfect all-around wrestler. Salvaje's got to find a way to counter whatever he's throwing out. And he's done a pretty good job so far, if I say so myself. Well, he gets thrown out of the ring. Let's see if he can counter this, because I think we know what Jackson's got in mind. Rebound off the ropes. There it is. Somersault senton through the ropes. See a replay of that one. Oh, by the way, Marilyn, thank you very much for bringing the logos back. You're a trooper. Salvaje's down on the ringside area. Got our ringside camera crew ready and willing. Tucker, what do you think of these new camera angles? I think they're really... The money was well spent.
Yeah, having multiple cameras like this, I mean, just being able to actually have, like, camera B, camera C, camera D operators.
Oh, my... Them.
Got new cameras. It's really nice having this kind of money.
We can focus on the action.
Jackson. Now, hopefully we could hire better studio operators.
Yeah, exactly. He throws Salvaje right underneath the camera. Oh, now Jackson, of course, playing to the camera. That's for you at home, ladies and gentlemen. Salvaje's not looking too good, though, after that somersault senton. He's very slow to get up, and the rest counting him out. Well, him out. Yeah, seven count. Salvaje going to be able to get up. Eight count. He's up, and he's in. Salvaje's in as Jackson flexes. Maybe not the right time to flex. Tilt-a-whirl arm drag.
When Salvaje does things like that, I don't know if there's a counter in the middle of that. I don't know. All I know is who gets sprawled out on the ground, and I know who is the victor in that tangle.
Exactly. Oh, nice kick to the face by Salvaje. Doesn't matter, Jackson. Irish whips him again. Clubs him right in the kidneys. That's one way to make your bathroom time fun. What's Jackson got in mind here? Oh, second rope neckbreaker. That was not pretty, but it was effective. Salvaje lands right on the back of his head.
One. Two.
Two count.
Oh,
just
man.
Just gets the shoulder
that
up.
That hand was on the mat.
Jackson.
His shoulder just gotten up, though.
Jackson's telling the ref, come on, you got to count a little bit faster than that. But either way, Salvaje just barely gets out of it. Stays alive. Takes Jackson off of him. He's got to find a way to get back in this one. Oh, Jackson drops down with a jawbreaker. Corkscrew elbow. He's feeling good. Jackson's looking like an Uprising champion right now. Salvaje not looking so much like a television champ so far.
No. Salvaje's definitely going to find a way to get back into this. Jackson, maybe some testicular torsion could do it, but...
Well, he hasn't pulled anything out of his bag of tricks yet, so we still
he's
got...
really had the opportunity. Jackson's just kind of been dominating the majority of this.
Look at the crowd going wild for Jackson. He's going to give him a second to cheer while Salvaje's just stirring. He just was out on his feet, but he catches the leg and hits him with a leg whip. Salvaje got mine here.
Oh. Tosses him into the ref. The ref just barely gets out of the way.
Chest first to the corner. Look at Salvaje. Look how slow he's moving. Oh, he slaps him in the face. Oh, never since Salvaje was the most respectful competitor. He's got mine here. He's got Jackson draped across that top rope. Oh, my God. He just...
Oh, my God.
We got to see that replay again. He just drove both his knees right into his midsection.
Oh. Like,
we're talking about Joel's bruised ribs. I wouldn't be surprised if Jackson's got some. Look at this. Wow. Hell, that might have even been low.
I think that was low.
I think maybe one knee hit the ribs, one knee hit the tallywhacker.
I think that might have been the point.
Salvaje now has just completely turned the tables. This is your television champion. He's looking like it once again. Spine buster. Jackson doesn't really know what's hit him. Oh, that might not have been the smartest move. No, Mike!
There it is. Got a baseball slide into the gonads.
Look at Salvaje now. He's on fire. The crowd really not as behind him as they are Jackson. But that's to be expected. Stomping on his legs and his backside. Rolling elbow. Jackson's gotten knees to his gut and maybe below. He's got that baseball slide, and now, oh no.
We're going to see it.
I didn't think we would see this again. I thought he would give this up. Please don't.
Oh, there it is.
Hey, he changed his course in midair. Did you see that? Look at this.
Huh.
He did. I think Salvaje is giving up that the shattered dreams. He just went for a 630. Still damn impressive. Still very well might get him to win. One, two. No, my God. Jackson with the shoulder at two. Hell, you got to think if Salvaje went with the original plan, he might have got the win there. Either way, Jackson is holding his chest. Jackson's not looking too good. Yeah, we haven't seen Salvaje really do that since Granat did it to him. So I think he's still got some, trauma going for that. I think Jackson get back in this now? Oh, my God.
Looks like
it. Oh, my God. Those are vicious strikes. Look at Salvaje. He's draped across that lower rope.
Oh, this isn't going to be good.
Drop kicks him. Oh, my God.
Only way that could be worse is if he was further over.
Let's see that replay again. Look at this. Right on the apron he lands. That's perfect athleticism.
And the only way that could have been worse is if his head was against the pole.
Imagine, but I don't think Jackson said that vicious, but he's calling for something. Is he going to call for that good night, the good luck? We've seen both recently. Let's see what he pulls out. Salvaje's got to fight out of this. I don't think he can. Good night. Right on the top of his head. That could be all she wrote. Look at this. Suplex into a pile driver. Not many people can get into that one.
I think that's it.
Going for a cover. Hooks the leg.
One, two, three.
That's it. Jackson Montgomery, your Uprising champion, pulls out a hard-fought victory over the television champ, Salvaje. That was a hell of a main event, Tucker.
Yeah. Salvaje's definitely... Definitely got a lot of groundwork to do.
I mean, let's not take away. He had a very, very impressive showing in the second half of that match. He almost had Jackson. I think that audible he called in midair really just cost him. And I'm glad he did, honestly. I don't like to see that move. That's devastating.
I wouldn't want to feel that move.
I mean, it might have just cost him a win. I think that's why he did it, honestly. I think he's felt it. But now that he knows how it feels. Of course, that doesn't really stop him from doing the other stuff. But... I guess lessons have to be learned the hard way. But Jackson Montgomery with another big win. This man has been on a roll since he came back. He hasn't lost a match. So
how long is he going to keep it going?
Now we'll have to see. But join us next week as Tucker takes on Otto. Masahiro takes on Pierce and more.